But here's how this morning is expected to play out. A lot's going to happen. The meeting will take place in a lakeside mansion in Geneva's largest park. President Putin is expected to arrive first at 7 a.m. Eastern Time. We'll see if that happens, followed by President Biden shortly thereafter. After being greeted by the Swiss president, the three leaders will then appear together before the cameras, where only the Swiss president is expected to make remarks. Then, the meeting, Secretary of State Tony Blinken will accompany President Biden for the first phase, while Putin will have his foreign minister. Each side will also have a translator. The meeting will then expand into five senior aides on each side. It's expected to last about 4 to 5 hours with some breaks. After the meeting, President Putin will hold a solo news conference, followed by President Biden. The two leaders first met in 2011 when the vice president said he looked into then Prime Minister Putin's eyes and told him he has no soul. They clashed again in 2014 when Biden, speaking for the Obama administration, condemned Russia's annexation of Crimea. And today there is another list of issues on the table, a lot of them, from hacking to election interference to human rights. And we have a big lineup this morning to help sort through all that is at stake, including former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, former Defense Secretary and CIA Director Leon Panetta, former National Security Advisor and UN Ambassador John Bolton, and former U.S. Ambassador to Russia Michael McFaul, who was with Biden for his 2011 meeting with Vladimir Putin.
So, David Ignatius, I saw an op-ed yesterday in the Wall Street Journal that was basically saying that Biden was all talk and no action, brought up things like Ukraine, Georgia. I mean, you go down the list. And, of course, it was all the list of terrible things that Vladimir Putin has done since 2008. No American president has really had the answer to Georgia, what we do with Crimea. They threw in South China Sea. It's just sort of little garnishing there. A lot of difficult issues here, not just for this president, but for any president. What do you do with a problem like Vladimir Putin?
So this has really deviled American presidents. Putin is a tough customer to deal with. He doesn't want predictability. He wants volatility. He's a little bit like Donald Trump in that way. He'd like to throw a grenade and see how you react. He's got a chip on his shoulder that now must weigh a couple tons. You can see that. I think one of the reasons he always slouches, he got so much on his shoulder.
By the way, that chip is 21 years old. I mean, we were talking a decade ago about the chip he had on his shoulder. I think Mika and I, back in 2010, around that, saw Lavrov being interviewed by David Remnick, and he had a chip. I mean, seriously, this is a decade
long. To be taken seriously, to be recognized as a leader of a great power, which the Soviet Union was, and Russia barely is, I think defines Putin. I think that Joe Biden did something really smart in speaking directly to that need that Putin has by saying he's a worthy adversary. I'm going to sit down with a worthy adversary. And the thing that Putin wants most to be taken seriously, Biden said, okay, I take you seriously. We're going to get together for a summit. And we'll see if there is productive business beyond that that they can do. I suspect, actually, that we'll come out with several agreements. There's already an agreement to return ambassadors, which is going to be a positive development.
And, Gene, going back to Barack Obama, when he called them a regional superpower, that may have accounted for some slumping, and also, more seriously, just feeding in to that deep resentment.
That was a different approach to Putin, right? Try to sort of diminish him a bit and take let a little air out of the Putin ego, but that didn't work either. I mean, the fact is Russia has to be taken seriously. They got 9,000 nuclear weapons. Russia will always have to be taken seriously. And I always think back to Putin saying what a great disaster it was that the Soviet Union dissolved, the right. Soviet empire dissolved, essentially.
The great tragedy of the 20th century, geopolitical tragedy of the 20th century.
Exactly, and he, you know, sees himself as kind of czar of all the Russians.
And, right.
And
well, this meeting was Biden's idea. The initial reach out was made in April, and Willie, on Monday, Joe Biden said he will make it clear to Putin what the red lines are. And if he chooses not to cooperate and acts in a way that he hasn't passed relative to cybersecurity and some other activities, then we will respond. So he's going in there hot.
And the question is, what does that mean? If he crosses the red line, as Putin has many, many times just in the last few weeks in these cyber attacks, what is the American response? And Katie, if you look, part of this entire trip for Joe Biden has been about showing the contrast from the last 4 years and bringing America back, as the president put it. You watch that clip from Helsinki where Jonathan Lemire asked the president to say, sitting on the stage with Vladimir Putin, that he shouldn't have appeared in the election, and the disgraceful response where Donald Trump wouldn't do that. This is about, in many ways, for Joe Biden to stand up there, not on a stage with Putin, because there won't be a joint presser, but to stand up there and call out publicly Vladimir Putin for all the things he's done.
Yeah, I mean, to a large extent for Joe Biden, the audience for this is right here in the United States, not necessarily around the world. And it's a moment for him to reset and show, as he has done in so many ways, that he is not Donald Trump, he's not his predecessor, and that he's going to be tougher on Russia. And the question is, what does be tougher mean, and what are the tools left in the American toolbox, in the Western toolbox, that they haven't yet used? Things like, I think the biggest issue on the table probably is cyber, because we've seen those ransomware attacks pick up enormously over the course of the last few months. Is there something that America is thinking that it could use if those attacks carry on? Is that something he's going to bring up?
You mean like countermeasures?
Because
it seems to me at this point, another round of sanctions does absolutely no good. You're going to have a counter reaction to a cyber attack.
There's some talk about taking sanctions out against getting closer to Putin himself, right? So if you really sanctioned the people who are very close to Putin, would that then get back to Putin? That hasn't been done yet. So that's one possibility. But I think the countering of cyber measures is the one that American intelligence officials are really looking at and really weighing if these attacks. And is it possible that Putin thinks, actually, you know what, I've created a monster that might have got a little bit out of control, and I want to rein in. He has an interest in reining
back. Well, he doesn't seem to be. I mean, his latest comments, and especially talking to Keir and others, talking about Trump being remarkably brilliant, and he was playing to an audience there that was not pro-Biden.